नमस्कार, आई एम डॉक्टर नवदीप सिंह बैंस, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन बॉटनी, डूंगर पीजी कॉलेज बीकानेर, राजस्थान। टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग विद यू द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ सेकेंडरी मेटाबॉलिज्म एंड सेकेंडरी मेटाबोलाइट्स। As you know, the plants contain many pathways of primary metabolism which are not found in animals. Another aspect of metabolism which distinguishes the plants and animal kingdoms is that the plants and fungi contain diverse pathways leading up from primary metabolism which are not essential to the survival of the organism. Such peripheral pathways are collectively termed secondary metabolism and are very rare in higher animals, although they are occasionally encountered in insects and other invertebrates. The products of these peripheral pathways are termed as secondary metabolites and have been defined as endpoints of metabolism with no strictly defined function. These are earlier supposed to be the endpoints of metabolism with no strictly defined function, but as some this definition is no longer wholly tenable, as some crop products derived from secondary metabolism, such as the cell wall polymer lignin, certainly are essential to terrestrial plants. Similarly, several plant hormones and isoprenoid derived carotenoids and esterols share some similar routes of biosynthesis to the classical secondary metabolites, but these products clearly do have functions in plants, so we cannot quote them as a endpoint of the metabolism with no strictly defined function. Even when restricting ourselves to considering the secondary metabolites of plants rather than fungi, the diversity of compounds is astounding. Many thousands of secondary products have been described from the diverse selection of higher and lower plants. More are continually being characterized. So, in addition to their intriguing chemistry, the motivation to characterize plant secondary metabolites is often driven by commercial interest, as they have been the source of many valuable drugs, pesticides, and chemicals important to food industry. These secondary metabolites present in all plants, rare in higher animals, and occasional in insects and other invertebrates. And if we see the difference between primary and secondary metabolism, there are no fundamental differences between secondary and primary metabolism. Similar chemical reactions take place, and in both cases, complex molecules synthesized from simple precursors by multiple enzyme-catalyzed reactions. And in both cases, complex molecules are synthesized, but primary and secondary metabolism only differ only in the degree of flux through the respective pathways and in the how they are regulated. Means primary metabolism accounts for the majority of the total utilization of carbon, nitrogen, sulfur in plants, and most routes of secondary metabolism accounts for only trace quantity of metabolite. You can see in this slide that primary metabolism accounts for the majority of the total utilization of carbon, nitrogen, and sulfur in plants, while most routes of the secondary metabolism accounts for only trace quantities of metabolites. And primary metabolism is subject to complex regulation by the action of allosteric enzymes. This is the main characteristic difference between primary and secondary metabolites, that primary metabolites are regulated by the action of allosteric enzymes, while these allosteric enzymes are absent in the later steps in secondary metabolic pathways at diversion, subject to complex regulation, because secondary metabolites are regulated by the action of branch point enzymes, not allosteric enzymes. And however, there are a limited range of primary metabolites from which secondary metabolites are derived, and numerous secondary metabolites are derived, namely such as phosphoenol pyruvate, pyruvate, acetyl coenzyme A, 3-phosphoglycerate, oxaloacetate, alpha oxaglutarate, and the alpha amino acid derived from these compounds. And as I stated about the branch point enzymes, which are very essential coenzymes for the regulation of secondary metabolites, the first step is the in the synthesis of secondary metabolite involves a branch point enzyme which is responsible for committing a defined amount of primary metabolism into secondary metabolism, and is frequently cited as the controlling step in the pathways. As in phenolic secondary metabolites such as lignin and flavonoids, these branch point enzymes are PAL. PAL means phenyl alanine ammonium lyase. These phenolic derived from phenyl propionate, the branch point enzyme is phenyl alanine ammonium lyase, which catalyzes the deaminative reduction of phenyl alanine to yield the phenyl propionate transaminic acid. And in the case of alkaloids derived from amino acids, the first committed step is decarboxylation of the respective amino acid, and thus the branch point enzymes are decarboxylases. And in third case, for isoprenoid pathways such as carotenoids and esterols, carbon is diverted from the synthesis of primary metabolites such as carotenoids and esterol by enzymes such as sesquiterpene cyclase to form bioactive secondary products. And this this branch point enzyme PAL shows many of the characteristic features of a branch point enzyme and is well studied both at the protein and gene level. PAL is present as multiple isoenzyme, with each isoenzyme composed of 475 kilodalton polypeptides, and in many plant species the PAL subunits are encoded by a multi-gene family, with each gene being subject to distinct regulation in response in stress and development. Thus, different PAL isoenzymes are expressed in plant cells in response to stress or when phenylpropionoid derived metabolites such as lignin and flavonoid fluoropigments are required. And in the absence of these, PAL activity is normally very low in healthy resting cells. PAL activity is also subject to control by light. It means by the thioredoxin system in photosynthetic tissues and by protein turnover. Now, there is a clear difference between primary and secondary metabolites. We can generally call primary metabolites as primary products also and secondary products. And these products are from primary metabolism, whereas secondary products are from secondary metabolism. And primary products are universal in their distribution, while the distribution of secondary metabolites is restricted in few plants and few cells and few tissues. And these primary products are very simple in structure, while secondary metabolites are very complex in structure. And these are the some example of primary metabolites such as amino acids, ascorbic acids and common fats and lipids, common sugars and sugar derivatives, means carbohydrates, while the common examples of secondary metabolites are alkaloids, esteroids, flavonoids, coumarins, resins, tannins, salicylic acid, and some sterols and scopolamine, etc. Now, depending on the origin and function, metabolites can be divided into two major categories, namely primary and secondary metabolites, as I stated earlier. So, these primary metabolites are microbial products produced continuously during the exponential phase of growth and are involved in primary metabolic processes such as respiration and photosynthesis. And they include intermediate and end products of anabolic metabolism, which are used by the cell as building blocks for essential macromolecules, e.g., for example, amino acids, nucleotides, or are converted to coenzymes. For example, vitamins. Industrially, the most significant primary metabolites are amino acids, nucleotides, vitamins, solvent, and organic acids. And many of these metabolites are manufactured by microbial fermentation and isolation instead of chemical synthesis, because the fermentations are economically competitive and produce biologically useful isomeric forms. And these and microbial secondary metabolites are compounds produced by an organism that are not required for primary metabolic processes, although they can have important ecological and other functions. And streptomycetes and related actinomycetes continue to be prolific sources of novel secondary metabolites. And microbial secondary metabolites include antibiotics, pigments, toxins, effectors of ecological competition and symbiosis, pheromones, enzyme inhibitors, immunomodulating agents, receptor antagonists and agonists, pesticides, anti-tumor agents, and growth promoters of animals and plants. And these secondary metabolites are derived by pathways in which primary metabolites involve. Therefore, secondary metabolites are considered as the end product of primary. Hence, secondary metabolites or natural products can be defined as a heterogeneous group of natural metabolic products that are not essential for vegetative growth of the producing organism, but they are considered differentiation compounds conferring adaptive roles, for example, by functioning as defense compounds or signaling molecules in ecological interactions, symbiosis, metal transport, and competition, and so on. The multitude of secondary metabolites secretions is harvested by humankind to improve their health. These secondary metabolites are very useful for human beings, as we can have antibiotics, enzyme inhibitors, immunomodulators, anti-tumor agents, and growth promoters of animals and plants, widen the pyramid of health, nutrition, pigments, and nutraceuticals, enhancing agriculture productivity, means by means of pesticides, insecticides, effectors of ecological competition, and symbiosis and pheromones, and hence impacting economics, our society in certain positive way. They are a good source of antibiotics. So these secondary metabolites are very useful for human beings and for living organisms of this earth. However, these secondary metabolites are supposed to be the end products of the primary metabolism, and not very useful plants. And plants tend to get rid of them from their plants with the deposition in the leaves, old leaves, and these old leaves defoliate from the plants, and these plants are get rid of them in very natural way. This is the complete overview of secondary metabolism, you can see all these secondary and primary metabolites are produced from a single precursor, is glucose, which is formed as a result of photosynthesis. And you can see here there is the origin of isopentanyl pyrophosphate, IPP. You can see here this is IPP, isoprenoid. The activated isoprene used to build up terpenes in animals. You can see in animals IPP is derived from mevalonic acid, which is synthesized from acetyl coenzyme A. This mevalonic acid is synthesized in animals, and you can see there are two pathways for the production of secondary metabolites, that is pyruvate pathway and shikimate pathway. And as I stated earlier, that these mevalonic acid, this reaction take place in animals, but as in the case of microbes, however, recent studies have shown that this pathway does not operate in microorganisms. This pathway does not occur in microorganisms, which make IPP from glucose via deoxyxylulose. In microbes, the IPP is produced with the production of 6-deoxyxylulose. Plant appears to use both pathways to make IPP, with monoterpenes and carotenoids synthesized in the chloroplast from deoxyxylulose and esterol synthesized from mevalonate in the cytosol. Means, in plants, both these pathways can occur, but this pathway occur only in animals and this pathway occur only in microbes. From the summary of secondary metabolism, it is obvious that the diversity of secondary metabolites can only be derived from the later stages of their synthesis rather than from the multiplicity of their origin. Secondary metabolism can be further simplified by identifying features which are common to various biosynthetic routes. And you can see this alkaloids are produced with the help of aliphatic and aromatic amino acids. The production of aromatic amino acids is only through shikimate pathway. And the branch point enzyme, you can see here, decarboxylase, the action of decarboxylase branch point enzyme, these aliphatic amino acids and aromatic amino acids may produce alkaloids. And in this pathway, from shikimate pathway, from hydroxybenzoic acid, the phenyl propanoids may convert into flavonoids with the help of PAL enzyme. PAL means phenyl alanine ammonium lyase. This PAL enzyme is responsible for the production of phenolic metabolites. These are phenolic metabolites, and these phenolic metabolites may consider as complex flavonoids. And the third branch point enzyme is, as I stated earlier, IPP cyclases, means isoprenoid sesquiterpene cyclases, which are responsible for the production of biosynthesis of complex isoprenoids, means esterols and carotenoids. So these both pathways you can find in plants from TCA cycle and from deoxyxylulose. And decarboxylases branch point helps in the production of alkaloids, while PAL branch point enzyme phenylalanine ammoniumlase is responsible for the production of phenolic secondary metabolites, means flavonoids. So friends, there are so many other types also present of the branch point enzyme in secondary metabolites, like oxytransferases, oxygenases and methyl transferases, and there are so many examples of these complex flavonoids like salicylic acid, scopolamine, tannins, and isoprenoids, esterols, carotenoids, terpenoids, and all these examples I will discuss in my next session. So you must learn these overview very sincerely, and you must remember that this is the main, you can see here, when photosynthesis occurs in plants, this is the primary metabolic pathway of carbon, and with the process of glycolysis and pyruvate formation, acetyl coenzyme formation, you can see mevalonic acid formation, and these are primary metabolic products. You can see shikimic acid here, aromatic amino acids, which is formed with the help of shikimic acid, and aliphatic amino acids are produced with the as the intermediate products of Krebs cycle, and all these are corresponding secondary metabolites like tannic acids, simple phenols, benzoic acid and its derivatives, lignins, lignin and lignins, phenyl isoprenoids, comerins, alkaloid, peptides, cyanhydrin, sulfurate, peptides, flavonoids, xanthones, and all these terpenoids, fats and waxes, these are terms as secondary metabolites. So these natural plant sources which are termed as secondary metabolites, we can extract it out with the help of bioreactors and fermenters, and these secondary metabolites are terpenoids, alkaloids, flavonoids, glycosides and phenolics, which are widely used in the production of perfumery and pharmaceuticals, medicines, drugs, foods, cosmetics and textiles. And this is one more overview of the production of secondary metabolites. The primary source, as always, carbon dioxide, which fix in the process of photosynthesis to form primary carbon metabolites like erythrose phosphate, phosphonyl pyruvate, and these are the different pathway for the production of secondary metabolites, that is shikimic acid pathway and pyruvate pathway, and this is MEP pathway, means mevalonic acid pathway, and these are three categories showing of the secondary metabolites, like nitrogen containing secondary metabolites, alkaloids, glucosinolates, cyanogenic glycosides, and these are some phenol compounds, flavonoids, comerins, lignin, tannins, and these are terpenoid compounds, isoprene, saponin, monodi and triterpenes, carotenoids and phytohormones. So this is the introductory part of my this presentation about the secondary metabolites, and in further discussion I will present you the individual description of the secondary metabolites like flavonoids, alkaloids, etc. Thank you. Okay.